guys, I'm here at Ekurhuleni Agricultural College. As you can see behind me, we are being shown what is here, what you're going to expect here if you consider to enroll here. So this is our workshop. So this is where the students will begin about these machines that we are going to use now. You can come and show them. So tractor Ganda Ganda, it's informal knowledge. The parts. Yeah, you can do that. I like that. The other one. What do you call this? It's a scuffle. Oh, it's a maize blender, this one. It's a maize blender. Okay, guys, so now we are here on the tunnel of the greenhouse. As you can see behind me, or maybe on my side, there's green paper, and if you look there, that side, there's cabbage, there's also tomato, there's also beans on the other side. So we are going to move you, and don't forget, we are here at the Ekurhuleni Agricultural College. If you consider to come here, this is what we are going to see when you get here. We can proceed to the other side. We're going to see other plants. Okay guys, so now we are on the other section. This is where the poultry farming takes place. But there are no chickens or sheep, as you can see. So it's another side. That means that the chickens or the sheep that we hear, they finished the production cycle, they sold them out or they were slaughtered. Now there's a new stock that's going to come here. You see, this is the equipment that you need for poultry farming, your feeders, your drinkers, these are the lighting, I believe, your for infrared lights and all of that. This is where they brought the chicks or keep the chickens. Yeah, and then this is where they take this is where they record, you know, if you are doing your vaccination program, you're going to record here, and all the check-ups and everything that you need to record, you're going to record it here. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay guys, so now we are in the layer chicken house. As you can see behind me, there's cages all the way from there up there, and then the other one from there up there. This is a huge chicken structure, you know. I believe that they keep thousands of layers here. You can see the layers, automated system with drinkers and feeders. And like I said on the other side, that there is no layers now, because the layers that were here, they finished the production cycle. So now there are going to be new layers that are going to be brought here, right? So thank you. Now we're going to move. Okay guys, we are on the other section of the college. As you can see on this side, this is the kraal. Oh, this is where the cattle are kept. So guys, if you want to come here, I mean, there's nothing that you're going to need. you're going to get practical experience like handling the confetti. And yeah, and you can see the students, this is where they work. Bayenza e animal production, so they work here. And then you said this is the poultry, that side. Okay, that's where the poultry is. If you want to like do poultry farming, you're also going to get it there. So guys, I forgot to ask you the question about how long do the courses take here? Do you have like the 3-year courses all throughout, or you also have like 1-year course and something like that?
Yes, there is a 1-year course, which is most farming.
Okay.
It's animal production.
Okay. Okay, so guys, there's also a 1-year course that is mixed farming. You get to do your animal protection as well as plant protection. So if you don't want to be at school maybe for a long time, you can consider doing it. Yeah guys, so we are going to take a picture now. And bona send you children the attire, send me. Thank you. This is a clad for sheep, as you can see, this is where the sheep are. But you don't see them now because they are out grazing, you know. But if we came here later, we're going to find them here. And then this side, this is where the goats are kept. So it's goats here. It's goats this side. No, it's goats here and then it's sheep this side.
And then the dairy cattle and
the dairy cattle that side. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay guys, so this one is the upper top. Mm-hmm. This is where you're going to slaughter the chickens and other livestock, yes, that are here, your cattle and etc. Yeah. Okay guys, we are in the classroom now. As you can see, the students in my side, they are enrolled here at Ekuruleni Agricultural College. Yeah, so I'm going to ask them a few questions about what they are doing here. No, don't worry guys, I'm not going to ask you hard questions. I'm going to ask you what you're doing here. Yeah, so that more students and the audience from my YouTube channel can come and join the college. You know, and I'm sure you don't know me. When I'm born, I'm from Johannesburg, but I'm passionate about agriculture. I love agriculture. You know, I'm going to join you sometime here. How do you know me? Okay, then how are you? I'm fine, thanks. Can you please tell us about yourself? What are you doing here? Why did you decide to come and start here? I hear that you grew up in a farm. I know some other people, they would say that, you know, I already have all the information that I need. So why did you come to enroll here? Or maybe in fact, like, there were more things that you didn't know.
Thing is, with education, you can never say that you have learned enough. Yeah.
Yes.
So, and another thing is, out of all the schools that I looked at, this school was 70% practical inside the institute, and it was 30% theory, meaning it's an advantage, because in other schools, you do your practical theory there, then you go out to look out for a farm where you can do that. So when I enrolled here, I swear it was an advantage for myself, because I'm going to do both theory and practical. And what I loved most was that you do 70% practicals. With theory, you can
great. You can hear, guys, you know, on our group, Facebook group, Agriculture and Young, there's always young people there who are complaining that they are looking for in-service training farms. So you see that when you come here, you won't need to go and look for in-service training because you are going to get it here. So I would really encourage, if you are still looking to start your career in agriculture, to look into Ekurhuleni Agricultural College, because you are going to get the training here. You won't do the practice there, the theory, and then have to go and look for a farm. So where are you staying? Do you stay here?
I stay up here at the campus.
The campus. Okay, so they do have accommodation.
Yeah.
Okay. How is it like? Is it nice because everything is just here? Or you would have preferred to stay in another place?
No, it's nice staying here because of that way you can get everything around the campus, and it's for yourself, because you know I'm from around here, all of us, and you know how people are. When they see colleges, they can get chances with other.
Okay.
They can do such things to people, so it's nice staying here because they can get much, they can learn from you, they do all those kinds of things.
Okay. Okay, that's nice. What a convenience for anyone who wants to come here. So, the last question that I'm going to ask you is, I'm going to have to cut that part. I wanted to ask you, okay, it's fine. This is a weird pool. So guys, would you encourage young people to come and enroll here?
Yeah, I would encourage
great, guys. You can hear that the Minister of Education said that if you want to have a sustainable career, you need to go to like energy and agriculture. You know, guys, we are no longer in the time where we used to believe that you have to be in the office space in order for you to like have a career. You know, you can have a career in agriculture. So I encourage you guys, the viewers of this video, to start thinking about agriculture. If you are still in high school, I would really encourage you to consider going into agriculture, because like I said, there is no time where we're going to say we don't need food, you know. Okay, so guys, what are you doing here? What are you studying?
I'm studying animal production.
Animal production, okay.
3 years.
3 years,
mm-hmm.
Okay. How is it so far? Which level are you in now? Okay, which is your second year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's nice. And are you enjoying what you're doing?
I am. I'm enjoying
it. Okay, that's why you decided to. That's why you decided to choose agriculture.
Yeah.
Would you encourage young people to come and join agriculture? You know that young people, they don't perceive agriculture as something that can be done by young people. So would you encourage young people to come and join agriculture?
Yeah, I can encourage them to come, because for the next following years, agriculture is very nice because it's something that you can do on your daily basis, and then it's not like other works. For example, for the next following years, maybe there will be no teaching, they'll be studying online, but then agriculture...
It's going to be there.
Yes.
Okay. That's nice, and it reminds me of what they say, that you know, everyone should start thinking about agriculture, because there's not going to be a time where people are not eating, you know. And in order for us to exist, we depend on agriculture. So there's no way that we are going to consider agriculture something that can be done by old people or uneducated people, you know. So it's just time for everyone to start cementing themselves in agriculture. So I'm going to ask you, how are you? I'm fine, thank you. clients. So what's the advantage of getting like 70% of practical experience here and then 30% of the theory?
Well, in here it's unlike in university.
Yes.
Then you can get 70% practical, of which is very helpful.
Yes.
Because like you learn and you do practical,
yes,
which is it's a very easy thing.
Okay.
Yeah, you get to understand fast.
That's great. That's great. You know, I also like what it is. I don't want to lie. Because like they prepare you for what you want to do, you know. I believe that everyone who's here will be in a position to go and start their own farms after here.
Yes.
Right. Okay. That's nice. And how are you? I'm fine, thanks. So what are you studying here? What are you studying here?
Animal production.
Animal production. Okay. How is it so far? Would you encourage other young people to come and join the institution?
Yeah.
Why? Why did you do agriculture in high school?
Yeah.
You did it?
Yeah.
Okay. Is it a requirement that if you join the institution you should have done agriculture in high school?
No.
Anyone can do it?
Yeah, it's level 2.
That's great. You can hear, guys, that you don't need to have agricultural background. So someone like me who didn't do agriculture in high school, you can still come and join the institute. Okay. Hello, how are you? I'm fine, James. So can you please take us through what does the 30% theory constitute? Like, what do you do there? I know that in the 70 part, 70% part of the practical experience, you get to be practical in outside or in the tunnels out there or in the workrooms on the other side. So what do you do in the 30% part of the work? I can see that you have a big fire here. Can you like take us through that? What can you tell us about it? Or why do you like it as opposed to crop production? You just like working with meat, maybe?
No, I just love working with animals. I prefer working with animals.
Okay.
So that's why I have a passion for animals. It's just like, all I want to do poetry for me.
Okay.
I'm done with my dream. So here's why I'm doing production.
Okay, that's nice. That's nice. You're great to do it. I can't wait to visit your farm after you're done. Okay. Let's move to the other side. How are you? I'm fine, Grace. Can you please tell us what are you studying here?
I'm studying animal production.
Yes.
For 3 years.
For 3 years. So this is your first year?
My first year.
Okay. How was it like when you got here? Was it easy transitioning from high school to here in the college or?
Not easy at all because I did a different subject.
You didn't do agriculture in high school? Okay.
So I had to adjust to get to level 1
Okay. Why did you decide to do animal production after you did do the agriculture in high school?
Because
want to work for anyone. That's nice. That's nice. I like what you're saying. I guess that's why you decided to come to this institute, right? It was also going to give you like the practical that you need as opposed to other institutions where they like to maybe have a cultural management. You want to manage your own thing, you don't want to go and manage someone else's thing. Okay, that's nice. I can't wait to see your success story. Hello, good morning. Thanks. What are you studying here?
Agriculture production.
Animal production. Okay. Why did you decide to come here?
Agriculture is probably the
content here, guys. I don't have anything to add on that. I mean, if you are not in agriculture, you should start reconsidering where you are. Where are you going to eat if you are not in agriculture? Yeah. So can you please tell us, what does the animal protection entail? What do you do there?
Okay, so in animal production, basically we work with animals.
Yes.
So it consists of meat production, poultry.
Yes.
Yeah, so.
Okay. So after your qualification, you want to have your own farm.
Yeah.
You want to focus on the animals only. Which ones?
Not on animals.
Not only animals.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, well, I focus more on animal, but okay, agriculture, animal and plant work hand in hand, so
yes.
You can do animal, you can do plant, combine them, but focus more on
animal production.
Yes.
Okay, that's great. That's great. I wish you all the best when you go and start. It's nice seeing young people who know from the start of their careers that they want to work for themselves and not work for anyone and just have their own thing. Okay. Thank you. So yeah, thank you so much, guys, for allowing me to have a conversation with you in your class. Did I ask you a question?
Yeah,
I did. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, guys, now we are on the last section of the farm. As you can see behind me, this is where the cabbage is. There's been actually a lot of time. And then there they have small seedlings that they planted. See the cabbage, it's big, and all this work that you see here is by students who study at this institution. Okay, guys, so now we are in the rooms, or the res, popular known as the res. This is where the students stay for the duration of their studies. As you can see the setup here, we are in a two sharing room. There's the bed there, there's the bed there. This is the locker. This is the locker where they keep their clothes and everything. And each room, it has its own bath. It's a bathroom and there's toilet and shower on the side. So guys, you have everything here. I don't think there's anything that you're going to need. The convenience is here. So all the rooms are like that, but we're going to just show you around the entire res.
Yeah. Yeah.
vans, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, guys, so this is the laundry. This is where the students wash their clothes. Yeah, and remember, if you are staying here, there's laundry included for the students. And you said that the laundry, by Angela, right?
Yeah.
Yes. So you don't need to worry about washing your clothes. They are washing your clothes for you. And also being staying on the rest, it also means that you're going to get 3 meals each day. Yeah. So yeah, thank you. We're going to now move to there, to the other side, the shop. Okay guys, so here we are in the kitchen. Yeah, we're in block A, so block A is for girls, and then the other blocks are for guys, right? So it's a dining hall here. As you can see, it's a dining hall, and the kitchen. This is where the students' meals are prepared. We said that there's 3 meals each day. So upon those two we're going to get the food. Right, and then this is the dining area or the dining hall. The students, they stay here and enjoy their food, or maybe take the food to your room. There's also a TV there. Yeah, so now we're going to move. Okay, guys, we are in the last section of the college. This is the shop where the students buy like small things that they're going to need here. And this is also where they keep the end products, like your chicken meat and the veg that they get from the plant production side. So yeah guys, if you want to come here, there's nothing that you're going to need because everything is here. I like the convenience of them having everything here. You know, there's even a shop here where they can buy their things. So now we are going to move and have a conversation with the CEO. Thank you.